You know AI. Hordes of killer robots we're all absolutely terrified of, right?
Not exactly killer robots, no.
While a healthy dose of fear isn't a terrible idea, AI's potential to do good is something we don't often talk about. AI hopefully holding the answers to some of the most diabolical dilemmas, developing new medicines, improving student outcomes, even creating solutions for climate change.
AI will be able to go through all of the global research and gather insights that no single human or team of humans could, and potentially give us new ways not just to generate energy, but to store it far more effectively than we do now.
It could even hold the potential to perform complex medical procedures with perfect accuracy and identify early signs of disease.
We can now map things like mental illness, and we can understand where those things live in the brain. And so that becomes really exciting because then we can start to maybe modify those parts of the brain.
Plus, as we've already learned, AI can help lonely Russian men spam thousands of women to eventually find their perfect match. And while it's often claimed AI spells bad news for jobs, that may not be the whole story.
New technology invents new things for us to do. If we think about the smartphone, before that existed, there was no such thing as an app developer. We now have 27 million app developers.
In fact, a recent study shows 95% of employees expect it will improve their lives.
Jobs will become more interesting, less repetitive, and far more creative.
The Commonwealth Bank revealing this week that AI had already made its software engineers 30% more productive. So is AI just the victim of some bad publicity?
When the computer revolution happened, we entered the information age. Now with AI, we're going to enter the creativity age. There's going to be a creativity explosion where what we do rises above information and we add human insight to the possibilities of AI to create things we just can't imagine yet.
I've been listening to Sam Altman a lot. He's the CEO of OpenAI, and whenever I finish, I go, I've got a good feeling about this.
Right.
He's good spin. Good PR guy, I reckon.
Well, go on, spin it for us.
He's
the CEO of OpenAI.
Exactly. And I am listening, being like, I'm very impressed. He says that you can get a world-class education anywhere in the world. It's no longer about cities. What it can do with vaccine development, with, treatments for cancer, disability, like, that stuff to me is really, really exciting. And we've got some complex problems as, the human race that we have to solve. And if we aren't fiddling around with all the admin kind of mundane tasks and we can do higher order thinking while the robots do the rest, then I think that's a good thing.
But do you think there's a danger that the robots
so
doing all the
danger.
Mundane things are going to eventually develop into the higher level
Even
thinking.
Sam's worried about that. Not really? He's trying to have a bit of a positive.
Yeah. But between this point and the bombs, we're not doing admin. So what are we? Yay!